Hey everybody, welcome back to Wine Up TV. I'm your host Wayne, and on today's show we have three great wines from Italy. A Suave, a Primitivo, which is, they say it's like the sister grape to the Zinfandel, or vice versa. And then a really interesting indigenous varietal from Sicily called Nero d'Avola. So we're going to try these three wines when we come back. Stay tuned. Everybody, welcome back to Wine Up TV. Thanks for putting up with me. Hey, Italy's got a lot of different indigenous grape varietals, and I think it's important for us to start learning about different stuff besides your Chardonnays and Cabernets and Pinots and Merlots and Syrahs and so forth. There's a really interesting region in Italy, the DOC, called Suavia. The grape varietals is barely Garganagna and a little bit of Trebbiano and some Chardonnay. These wines were pretty much mass produced in the 60s and 70s and 80s. Now they're starting to have lower yields. So before they were harvesting between 6 and 7.5 tons of fruit per acre. So they're starting to get down a little bit on the yield, and they're starting to concentrate the wines a little bit more, so they're not as commercialized, so to speak. But this first one, this is the 2008 Suave Superior Classico Suavia. It's a DOCG, which is a denomination guarantita, so it's guaranteed by the Italian government that it comes from this region. And this is $16 a bottle. The nice thing with this wine, it got a 91 point in the Wine Spectator, which for those of you that like scores, that's fine. I'm not a score hater, I'm not a score denier. But we want to see on this this Suave right here, but some that are much lighter in color. This has got a nice pale golden straw hue to it, which really, really looks nice. This here, let's give this a little smell. Suaves are very interesting to start with. It's got that little flower petal going on, a little bit of cotton candy, a little bit of honey. It's a very nice nose. I've had a lot worse, but let's give this a little taste now. That's a really nice mouthfeel. You can tell it's been fermented in some large barrels. There's no oak, it's neutral, but because it hits the barrel, it's got that roundness to it and real nice richness, a real nice long lingering finish. This is definitely, I'm kind of surprised how good this wine really is. Again, it's got that cotton candy, honeyed, flowery nose. This is definitely a go-to wine. Just hang a fang in this stuff with some, just a nice grilled pork chop, even, you know, something lighter on the protein, or nice fish dishes. But this is a very good effort. Yum, I like that. I like that a lot. All right, next wine. We're gonna do the Primitivo first. We're going to go with the Lavelli Orion Primitivo. It's 100% Primitivo, 2007, $13 a bottle. And this region right here, this actually comes from the Salento region. It's on the boot of the heel, as Italy is, you know, the little boot. It's on the boot of the heel right there. So let's give this a little shot. This is a new wine to me. I've never had this wine before. I had somebody stop by and say, hey, check this out. So here I am checking it out. Again, $13 a bottle. Let's give this thing a little smell. Almost has that Zinfandel, raspberry, spicy, clovey kind of scent to it. Let that kind of blow off for a second. Alcohol content on this is... What's the alcohol content on this thing? I don't know. I should say somewhere. It's 13% right there, 13%. So let's get this little taste. It's a little flabby in the middle, mid palate. It's got some nice earthiness, nice spiciness to it on the front of your palate. Not a bad wine. Not great by any means, but not horrible by any means. $13 a bottle. This is a nice bottle of wine to take over to your friend's house. Sit down, talk about wine a little bit. If you had, I'd like to have a Napa Valley Zin or a Sonoma County Zin, Dry Creek Valley Zinfandel, and this one put next to each other, and to see which one kind of shines either way. A Primitivo Zinfandel, kind of similar in characteristics, going back and forth. But it's very, I don't mind it at all. Very nice. All right, last one we're going to have today. This is really interesting, from Sicily to its own little island down there. Indigenous grape varietal. This is, of course, the Nero d'Avola. Looks to me like it's going to be an interesting try. This happens to be $20 a bottle. I don't know the case production on it from Sicilia. Should be interesting. 2007 Lemuri Nero d'Avola. Again, you put this next to a regular bottle of wine, let's say like this Ponzi Pinot. A lot of people might know Ponzi, have no idea what this next wine is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try this wine. I like the color. The color is nice and dark garnet. Very nice. Good extraction out of this. 2007. I don't know much about the vintage, and I apologize, of Sicily in 2007. Let's give this a little smell. It's got that nice mushroomy, almost kind of a little stronger than a Pinot, if you will. But of course, absolute earth and a little alcoholic. I could smell that alcohol burn right in my nose. Not horrible, but a little bit higher in alcohol. It got that musty character. Like that, your kind of socks have been sitting for a little while. Not in a bad way, but just in a very earthy, kind of like stinky, but goodness kind of way. Let's try this now. I love discovering new grape varietals, and I'm sure you guys will as well. Nero d'Avola, very, very interesting. It's not bad. You know, I'm sorry, $20 a bottle. You know, I definitely consider getting a couple bottles of this and take them out and show your friends that there are really interesting grapes coming out of Italy, especially Sicily. Excuse me. All right, so yeah, a little spicy barbecue sauce with this. This might even just bring them all together. All right, so today we had some really interesting stuff from Italy. Some really fun wines. A Sauve, of course. The Garganega grape, which is indigenous to that region of the world. And then Primitivo. Big fan of the Primitivos. Love them. Love Zins. That's a huge favorite of mine. And the Nero d'Avola, which is very nice as well. All right, anybody, it's harvest time here in the Willamette Valley. If anybody wants to come around, take a tour, you know how to get a hold of me. Also, if you're ever in Beaverton, DeCarli, one of the best restaurants on the west side. I live in Beaverton, there's no other. I'm actually taking these guys around on Monday. Anyway, remember, always have a couple of glasses of great wine. I don't care if it's red, white, or pink, or sweet, or dry, or bubbly, every single day, and have a great, great week. Or weekend, whenever you're watching me. Stay tuned. I'm going to come back here shortly, and we're going to have another show. 3 more great wines from around the world. Peace.